Shalom, we want to give all praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashim Yahushai, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahushai. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and much love to the elect brethren on the four corners of the planet Earth that's been set up through faith to help seal the elect that the Lord brings in. Okay, Lord willing, we'll be a part of that number. We're going to jump into a quick update. The prophecies are screaming. They're screaming, man. Okay, all you say people that don't want to believe, you want to straddle the fence, you want to be in the middle. Well, the time is coming where you have to make that, how you say, decision. Now, they're moving with this chip because you have this Bitcoin craze that's going on. And that Bitcoin is leading into people, it's another form of money, okay? People are in trading Bitcoins back and forth and their whole mining. Brothers can look it up on YouTube. There's plenty of videos. Okay, so I'm just going to try to get to the, the gist of this story. So if you want to look up Bitcoin, just Wikipedia it, Google it. It'll tell you the whole breakdown of Bitcoin. It's digital cryptocurrency, okay? So we'll read this article. It says, by implanting a 12-millimeter glass computer chip in his flesh, Martin Wismijar, Slovakia for butchering that name, it's hard to pronounce, has been able to store Bitcoins inside his body, create a personalized alarm clock, and will even be able to install keyless doors in his home. But how painful is the injection? Okay, so let's watch this video and get into the scripts. Notice he's putting it in the right hand. Another person, a woman, because you women are going to be getting that chip too. There's about four people that got that chip right now in this just very video. That's another person. I just seen something, man. Look at his shirt. His shirt has a pyramid on it. and the D is right where the I would be. You see that? You see the luminary, the Illuminati, how you say code they're putting in there? Real quick, back this up. This is the book of Isaiah. This is the book of Isaiah 30 and we'll start at verse 2. And it says that walk to go down into Egypt and have no. It says, let me start at 30 and 1. It says, woe to the rebellious children. What children is it speaking of? It's speaking to the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, the children of Israel. It says, woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin, that walk and go down into Egypt, and have not asked at my mouth to strengthen themselves in the strength. It says, to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh, and to trust in the shadow of Egypt, because that chip is a shadow of Egypt, man. Because what is something of a shadow? A shadow passes away. Okay, a shadow is something, behind or comes after something. Okay, so America is the, how you say, the reincarnation of Egypt. But you're looking at it, they're trusting in the power of Egypt, and it's going to be that so-called new cryptocurrency or that digital currency, man. They're not going to, in the times of trouble, they're not going to ask of the Most High. They're going to trust in Egypt and Esau. Okay, Esau is the new Pharaoh. He is the leader of this world. That's why it says the earth is given into the hand of the wicked, so he's ruling right now. Just keep reading again. It says to talk that says to walk to go down into Egypt and have not asked of my mouth to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh and to trust in the shadow of Egypt. Therefore, all the strength of Pharaoh. It says, therefore shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame and the trust. It says, and the trust in the shadow of Egypt your confusion. For the princes of that's it on that. So that's showing you because if you receive this mark, that's going to be to your destruction at the end of the day. But the Most High is saying, look, you have to put faith in Yahweh Shem Yahushai in these times, man. Let me go to 31 and 1. This is the book of Isaiah 31 and 1. It says, woe unto them that go down to Egypt for help, and stay on horses and trust in chariots, because they are many, and the horsemen because they are very strong. But they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither shall seek the Lord. Yet he also, it says, yet he also is wise, and will bring evil, and will not call back his words. But all, it says, but will arise against the house of the evildoers, and against the help of them that work iniquity. See, there's the chip is moving, man. Okay, the chip is on its way. That's why the Lord and His graces has formed us and told us of these things. So real quick, this is a video. It says massive fleet, UFO fleet over Earth, because as these prophecies are coming to pass, the angels of the Lord are showing themselves. The angels have been out there, but now they're being more blatant with it. They're being right out front. They're showing themselves in fleets and massive in numbers, man. Alright, let's play this from here. I just thought that was a real cool little video, and I have this one too. It says, thousands see giant UFOs all over Australia. We'll read the article. It says, the UFO... It says the UFO activity over the last several months seemed to have intensified, and the sightings are more blatant and in the open. Australia has sent thousands in the, it says, has seen thousands in the last few months, and the most of them are being executed as strange cloud formations. Check out the video and photos and make your own conclusion. I believe this activity in Australia is HARP rather than UFOs in this case. Now, news has stated that these holes in the clouds are a natural phenomenon, which is incorrect. For it says if they had done their UFO research, they would have known about the 1657 Fort Bellwood case, where a U.S. soldier saw a metal ring in the sky over his base and he took a photo of it. However, while he took photos, the UFO created a white smoke cloud around it until it was 100% hidden from view. I have 50 magazines in which this case was first published, and also the 2006 O'Hara Air Force Airport UFO, where hundreds of people saw a gray disc hovering over gate C-17. After a few minutes, it suddenly shot up at an angle and as it went up, it went through an overhead cloud, leaving a perfect round hole in it for 15 minutes. I can go on and on, but that's necessary, is it? Slovakia. So these are the photos right here, and let's try to play this video of the cloud that had the rainbow in it.
Get off the road, Racy.
Afternoon.
Hello. The sheriff said went that way. Get off the road, Racy.
Afternoon.
Hello, how are you today?
Good, Carol.
You're good, lovely day. I've just witnessed, I'm in Lombardy, and I'm looking up at our clouds, and over Melbourne it's like the base of a huge ocean liner, and the front end of it had a rainbow in it. and apparently it's an extremely unusual occurrence.
Hang on, just go back here. You looked up at the sky.
Yes.
And what have you seen?
It looks like the bottom of a boat on water with the clouds, so it's got the outline of a boat, and the front end of it had a rainbow in it.
So were people taking photos?
People were taking photos. My daughter just looked up. She said it's a sort of rainbow, but it has to have water crystals, a certain temperature, and all sorts of things for it to happen.
Could you send
it? It was just incredible. Yes, I can send a photo.
If you could, just hold on there, Carol. We'll get some details, and we might be able to put that up at our website. Amazing clouds down Wonthaggi Way.
I wonder if it's a UFO delivering celebrities for the cup tomorrow.
Could be.
Alright, let's get to the next story. This is, it says Missouri National Guard on standby for Michael Brown grand jury decision. Okay, and somebody that I was watching said it pretty wisely. It said they wouldn't be calling the National Guard out if they were going to take this guy to trial. Okay, if they were already anticipating on taking him to trial, they wouldn't need the National Guard out preparing for riots and such things. Okay, so that's a preeminent move of showing this guy's not going to court. He's not going to get charged for it. It says, Governor announced policing plans for protests that could happen when grand jury decides whether to indict police officer who killed Michael Brown. It says the Missouri National Guard will be on standby to deal with any protest after a grand jury announces its decision on whether to charge the police officer who shot dead an unarmed teenager. Michael Brown, the state governor, announced on Tuesday. The governor, Jay Nixon, said the National Guard had been involved in extensive police planning for any eventuality after announcement of the decision by the juries considering the potential prosecution of Officer Darren Wilson, who killed Brown on 9th of August. National Guard forces will continue to be available when we determine it is necessary to support local law enforcement. Nixon told a press conference, "I am preparing to make that order," he said. At the time, operationally, that it is necessary to move forward, we will. Authorities around Ferguson, a northern suburb of St. Louis, are bracing for further unrest aimed widespread expectations that Wilson, 28, will not be indicted for the shooting, which took place in sharply contested circumstances after he stopped Brown and a friend for jaywalking. Intense protest in the days after Brown's death met a militarized police response that drawn sharp criticism from regional leaders and civil rights organizations. Nixon Tuesday declined to comment on whether the police were again preparing to use tear gas and rubber bullets. So I'll post the article, Lord willing. You brothers can check that out. Let me see the time. I'm gonna post this video. It's about an hour and 58 minutes long. It's very informative. It's by Vifa Gorilla. He's an economist. He goes into the money and the trading, and he brings out a lot of meat, man, a lot of meat. So it's a good video to watch. I'll post it, Lord willing, in the box so you brothers can check it out. I'll try my best. So with that, I'm gonna give all praise to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. Much love to the elect brethren on the four corners of the planet Earth that's been set up through faith. Lord willing, we be out of here soon, man. The prophecies are screaming. So I'm going to say shalom.